LDBC, this is your boy Coach Shelton Harrison. You're live, live, live on the Coach Shelton Harrison Combat Sports Show Live. Okay, guys, I've had several people ask me what my opinion was about this particular fight, and I wasn't even going to give my opinion on this because I got mixed feelings about this, but I'm going to give it to you raw. Don't get mad. You asked me my opinion, and I'm giving it to y'all raw, and that's just the way that is. You know, this is a very winnable fight for Holly Holm if it goes down, which, of course, is going to go down, and I'll tell you about that, too. This is a winnable fight. Okay. I favor 65-35 in favor of Holly Holm. Now, you know, people will say, you know, you gave Betts Correa a chance to win. I actually do give Betts Correa a chance to win. 35% in mixed martial arts, that's a big chance to win. Okay. Now, some people say, yeah, but Betts Correa got knocked out by Ronda Rousey and Holly Holm knocked out Ronda Rousey. First of all, folks, I don't believe in triangle theories because my boys over at 10 Players News, they described it best, okay? And I'm going to tell you how they broke it down, which is going to make sense. Shout out to 10 Players. Okay, a mongoose can kill a cobra, right? A mongoose can kill a cobra. A cobra is dangerous, but a mongoose can kill a cobra because of how the styles match up. But the same cobra can go kill a lion, but the lion can kill a mongoose simply because the styles match up. The mongoose can kill a cobra, the cobra can kill a lion, and a lion can kill a mongoose. Now, I hope I just didn't mess up some of y'all heads like 10 Players News did, but, folks, that's just the way that is, okay? It's how the styles match up. Betts Correa showed me something in her last fight, okay? Because I expected Betts Correa to come out and become a mauler. I thought that's what she was going to do, but she didn't do that. Betts Correa actually had a strategy, and she stood back and she became a counterpuncher. And I was really shocked that how good her counterpunching was, okay? Betts Correa is a decent counterpuncher. Not a great counterpuncher, but she's decent, okay? Now, why do I say this? Because Holly Holm struggles against two different styles, okay? She struggles. One, we know for a fact she struggles against counterpunches, okay? Because Valentina Shevchenko and Jermaine Durandamé, they were both excellent counterpunchers. Holly Holm struggled in both of those fights. And I don't care what you guys say. You can say that, you know, that Jermaine Durandamé cheated in this. But look, you take away those two blows for some of you hardcore, you know, fanboys. Jermaine Durandamé whooped Holly Holm ass, okay? Like, I had that fight easily. Jermaine Durandamé, what, 3 rounds of 2. And really, I could have said 4 rounds to 1, okay? And I don't have time to really explain why I would say 4 rounds to 1. But Jermaine Durandamé beat Holly Holm easy. And if they fought 100 times, Jermaine Durandamé would beat Holly Holm. Okay? It's how the styles match up. Valentina Shevchenko and Holly Holm, I mean, and Jermaine Durandamé, they know how to beat this style that Holly Holm poses. They know. Well, what about Betts Correa? Could she do it? Well, it all depends on what style she chooses. The second style that defeats Holly Holm is a grappler, but not just any grappler. See, folks, we need to understand that not just grapplers, because there have been a lot of grapplers in the octagon with Holly Holm, but they were unsuccessful. See, why was Miesha Tate unsuccessful? I mean, why was Miesha Tate successful? You have a lot of casuals that say, well, Miesha Tate won against Holly Holm because she got lucky. Really? How the hell does a world-class wrestler, grappler like Miesha Tate get lucky? I don't understand that. Miesha Tate is a skilled, she's skilled in that area. And she was trying to take Holly Holm down that entire fight. How did she get lucky? Miesha Tate trained for that months at a time. She trained that situation over and over and over. Miesha Tate did not get lucky. Miesha Tate knew what the hell she was doing. Miesha Tate is not any kind of grappler. She's a grappler that can grapple you at angles. See, you know, Holly Holm was used to dealing with a lot of grapplers that they come straight ahead. Miesha Tate didn't do that. Miesha Tate was grabbing her ass from angles. And that presented a problem for Holly Holm. If you are a grappler, you're very mobile. Like Miesha Tate is mobile, man. Miesha Tate is up on the balls of her feet. She's mobile, she's quick, and she's agile. If you can catch Holly Holm at an angle, you can beat Holly Holm if you're a grappler. See, people, you have to really start looking at this. And I think I am going to do a Miesha Tate film study on that particular fight. I'm thinking about it. I just don't want to get the video blocked or anything. But I'm going to do that. Because people have to really see that Miesha Tate was not lucky. But now, is Betts Correa going to have those results? I don't know. I don't think, with the skill set that Betts Correa possesses, I don't think she could beat Holly Holm. Now, I'm not saying it won't happen. I'm just saying I don't think that Betts Correa, with what she has right now, I don't think she defeats Holly. Okay? I think Holly is better on her feet than Betch Cohea. I think Holly Holm has a lot of range advantages over Betch Cohea. Like, Holly Holm has a lot of advantages over Betch Cohea. And also, too, I think Holly Holm is stronger than Betch Cohea. Holly Holm is a strong-ass girl. She's strong as hell. And taking her down is not easy, okay? It won't be easy. But for your grapplers, like Amecia Tate, who they can grapple you at angles, she was able to do so, okay? I think Holly Holm is on a three-fight losing streak. And I've said before, I don't think Holly Holm need to be fighting anybody in the top 10. Betch Cohea is top 10, and she's a dangerous opponent. I think Holly Holm needs to be fighting somebody with limited skills to get back in the win column. That's it. And then you put Holly Holm back in a fight. But see, I have a question. Why is Holly Holm still ranked number 5? She's on a 3-fight losing streak. Why is she still ranked number 5 in the bantamweight division? Why? How does that happen, y'all? Why? Well, I can tell you why. It's because of money. Okay, call it what you want. It's a money thing. Because, see, the person who should be fighting Betch Cohea at UFC Fight Night 111 is her. And y'all know who the hell this is. See, I got a handful of women in mixed martial arts, especially in the UFC. I got a handful of these women. They get shitted on by the UFC. And Mari Reynaud, the Belizean Bruiser, she is one of those women. This woman cannot catch a break. And for you, you want to come in a conversation, you're just saying that because you interviewed her. Shut the hell up. Because I call every fight right down the middle. All of y'all, shut up with that. Don't come at me with that rhetoric. I'm not trying to hear that. Every fight, I call it down the middle. Even if I like the fighter, I'll tell you if they lost. I'll tell you if they lost the fight. And that's just how it is. Okay? This woman been getting taken a dumped on ever since she's been in the damn USC. And I'm finna tell y'all. These are my thoughts. Okay, first of all, she get in the octagon. She delivered an ass-whooping to Ashley Evans-Smith. She beat Ashley Evans-Smith. Look, the fight should have been stopped a long time ago. She whooped Ashley's ass in that fight. Ashley was allowed to go the distance with Marion Reynaud. Ashley's face was messed up. She got her ass whooped. But she still wins a decision in that fight. People, I'm trying to understand. In the first round, Ashley Evans-Smith is damn near out on her feet. But she was allowed to finish the fight. And she wins a decision against Marion Reynaud, who dominated this fight. Marion Reynaud fought Dudieva. Melina Dudieva. Marion Reynaud won that fight. Beat the hell out of Dudieva. But it's like, okay, damn. Marion Reynaud is killing this girl. I'm talking about damn near almost hurt this girl severely. Beating, throwing elbows, punches, anything that Marion Reynaud could do. That's what she was doing. The referee taking his time stopping this fight. And I'm going to tell y'all something. I'm going to tell you something right now. Had Marion Reynaud went the distance with Dudieva, I think she would have lost on the scorecards again. See, there's a trend and pattern. She getting these referees that don't like to stop the fight. Okay? And I'm sorry. I don't care what y'all think. Oh, this conspiracy theory. Listen, y'all. The hell with all that. Because I'm telling y'all right now what it is. I'm telling y'all the person that needs to be fighting Betch Cohea at Fight Night 111 is Marion Reynaud. That's who should be fighting Betch Cohea. The rematch is warranted. The rematch is warranted. And then you get Marion Reynaud in the last round of the Betch Cohea fight. I mean, she put Betch ass in the hospital. And I was telling people, Betch Cohea got a concussion from that fight. And, of course, I was right. But y'all didn't want to believe that either. She got a concussion. She could have been saved from a concussion had the fight been stopped. See, let me tell y'all something. I don't care what y'all say. I don't care who come on here. You can disagree. That's fine. That's your right to disagree. I'm not going to argue with your opinion, but I'm not changing mine. Marion Reynaud is one of those people. She's on that no love list. And I'm telling you something. This woman right now is messing them up. And I'm going to tell you why she's completely screwing up the whole system. See, Marion Reynaud on paper, she's not supposed to be beating people. Not really. See, for Ashley Evans-Smith, Marion Reynaud wasn't even picked to win that fight. She wasn't. She was a heavy underdog. And she went in there and beat the hell out of Ashley Evans-Smith. She's most of the time was the underdog in the fight. And in the Dudieva fight, I don't think she was the underdog in that fight. I got to go back and check that. But I think Marion Reynaud was the favorite. But why was Dudieva allowed, man, to the last minute to try to recover? See, guys, we got to think about this. Three referees, same thing. And then Betts Cohea took a beating. Betts Cohea went to the hospital. Betts Cohea got a concussion. I'm just telling y'all now. Because Betts Cohea was damn near out. Okay, she was out. Why the fight wouldn't stop? Like, I'm trying to understand this. And even that, I still had to fight 2-1. Mari Reynaud won 2-1. I thought she won the fight. And the last round, damn, that was a 10-8 round, easily. But see, fighters like Marion, they never going to get their just due. It's just not going to happen. I don't care if Mari Reynaud work her way up the whole bantamweight ladder. Even if she wins a lot of fights decisively, she ain't going to get those wins. It's not going to happen. And yeah, she lost to Holly Holm decisively. Yep, there was no controversy there. She lost to Holly Holm decisively. Should there be a rematch between the two? Actually, probably so. I think this version of Mari Reynaud is a much better fighter, and I think she gives Holly Holm a much better fight this time. And that fight will be a little bit closer the second time around. Why didn't they pick Mari Reynaud? Why Betts Cohea? Why is Holly Holm getting these fights? Like, what the hell, man? I don't know. You guys tell me what you think. This is your boy, Coach Shelton Harrison. I'm done. What are you waiting on? Subscribe to the best women's MMA platform on YouTube.